Hi, I'm Treasurer Dennis Milligan. I'd like to welcome Arkansans to our office in the state capitol to view the new Arkansas Military Veterans Hall of Fame that was recently unveiled. Thank you to our nation's finest, both past and present, who have fought for the freedoms we all enjoy today.
Frank Kirby Cowan, deceased, was born in Harrison, Arkansas, and entered the Army Air Corps in 1942. Accepting his medallion tonight is his widow, Clotine Cowan. As a 20-year-old, Cowan was assigned as a radio operator and gunner on a B-17 with the 339th Bomb Squadron, 96th Bomb Group, 8th U.S. Air Force. On his 16th bombing mission, his plane was hit by enemy anti-aircraft fire. He bailed out and landed safely and made contact with someone he thought was a member of the French Resistance, but turned out to be a Gestapo double agent, who was paid 10,000 francs for each Allied airman he turned over to the Gestapo. The German Foreign Office decided not to give the 167 airmen POW classification, but branded them instead as terrorists. Cowan survived a total of 4 German prison camps, including Buchenwald, where many executions occurred. The prisoners were told they would be hung by piano wire. Mike Dorsey, a documentary filmmaker, captured the story in his 2011 film, The Lost Airmen of Buchenwald. Ironically, it was members of the German Luftwaffe, or Air Force, who eventually went to the aid of these prisoners. Fearing retaliation by the Allies, if word spread of their mistreatment, they were transferred out of Buchenwald only 10 days prior to scheduled execution to a prison camp run by the German Air Force. In 1945, Cowan was returned to the United States and discharged as a tech sergeant in September of that year with 100% disability. He earned the Purple Heart, 3 awards of the Air Medal, and the European African Middle Eastern Theater Ribbon with 2 battle stars. Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Kirby Cowan.